game, Super Mario Brothers.
Please God. Is everything... Everything seems to be... Okay. Maybe. How's everybody doing? I recently reinstalled Windows on my stream PC and this PC, but it looks like it's working. Looks like the webcam's there. Looks like everything's fine. Looks like everything's fine, except I don't see chat moving. Yeah. It was hiding. What's up, White Rabbit? It's still not scrolling to the bottom. Why are you doing this? Chat paused you to scroll. No. I want you to stay at the bottom. Go all the way to the bottom and stay there. Oh. That's a weird thing to have a problem with. What's up, Diogo? Thanks, Malcolm. Yeah, that's a deep reference to Konami's wretched greatest hits cover art. I played a little bit of Quake, the campaign. I played like the first act, but I've never actually played the full single player, nor have I... Dang it, it's still not scrolling. Is it scroll lock, maybe? Nor have I heard the soundtrack. I've never played the game with the soundtrack, so I'm going to do that. Let's see. Okay. Hold on. My stupid thing will not scroll. Wait, Volcar, you're losing your home? That's a hell of a thing to drop on a streamer. What's up? What's going on? What's happening with that? Everything is working? I don't know about that yet. Well, chat refuses to work, so that's interesting. Maybe that'll fix it. This game has a great soundtrack. Yep. Yeah. Wow. For some reason, my chat just will not fucking scroll. Like, it keeps scrolling off the bottom of the screen, and it won't stay at the bottom. What the hell? This is the dumbest thing to break. I spent all day fixing something else. Fixing my stream PC. Setting up all of my capture devices again. Reinstalling drivers for everything. Setting everything up. And now chat won't stay at the bottom of the window. I think I have a suspicion about why it's doing that. What a dumb thing. What a dumb thing. Why would you do that? Why would you be like this? Okay, there we go. It was, I think it was the smooth scrolling option. It seemed to be working, but then it's not working. But now, whenever I turned it off, stream was too dank for the bottom of the screen. That's true. All right, let's play Quake. Hopefully I sound good. Hopefully the game sounds good. I've only done a limited amount of testing with audio levels, so do let me know if something's too loud, too soft. Ooh, Yondo, thank you for the heavy text. Let me know if the capture looks good. Looks all right to me. This is what we do it for, though. This is why we do it. This is why we reinstall Windows for the 18 millionth time. Is this with RTX? So it's funny, there are a couple of RTX mods for it since it is open source. But no, this is not. Hear about the new Quake rumor? I did! That would be delightful, if true. I'm just kind of okay with whatever they want to make next. That team is pretty great, as far as I'm concerned. Ramp became too expensive. Didn't mean to drop bombs. It's just the highlight of my life at the moment. Kind of freaked out about it, but it streams like this that helps psychologically a lot. So honestly, thank you for what you do. If it was a painfully poor, I'd sub right now. No, don't worry about it. Yeah, that's. I'm very sorry to hear that, and I'm very I'm empathetic. I'll here. Hold on a second. Let me take down a note. Oh. That sucks. So you don't? Do you have anyone you can crash with? Or is it like you have like a week to find a couch kind of deal? Played Dark Forces on stream yet? I've played Dark Forces 2 on stream. But not Dark Forces 1, no. I'm multi-twitching you with two other girls. Threesome of me. Well, I mean, there's only one me there. Woo! But if there were three me's, then you'd have a real stream going. Oh, you know, I'm just bad. Glad to be included. But yeah, I've never played this game with the soundtrack before, because I always just played the Steam distro and never got far enough into installing community tools to enable the soundtrack. But that is the case no longer. And it's adding a lot. It's not. I understand what people were saying. Like, it's not quite music. It's more like a environmental audio. But even using the soundtrack for that is pretty progressive at the time. What is the native frame rate? I'm playing it at 120 since VSync is on. I mean, as far as frame rate goes, this was one of the first, like, properly coded 3D games. So theoretically, you can run as fast as a computer can possibly run it. I don't think there is any upper bound on frame rate. How do you choose the games you'll play on the stream? Curious about your process if there is one. There kind of isn't, no. It's a small mix of, like, what I've noticed performs well on either Twitch or YouTube. But largely, and I'm very blessed to be able to say this, it's mostly just whatever I feel like at any given day. I had been tinkering with Quake. I'm actually not sure why. I think it's because QuakeCon is coming up. And I was like, yeah, Quake. And I was like, I really want to hear the soundtrack. That was kind of where my head was at. So I installed it, kind of tweaked it out, got it working. Got it running modern-wise. Yeah, giving the new hardware a real workout. This is the core of PC gaming. It's installing a brand new upgrade and then playing a game from 30 years ago. You're my favorite internet personality, so it's comforting to feel like I'm there. Unfortunately, all my family lives in the UK, and I don't really have any friends here, so talk about being in the middle of nowhere. Urgh. I'm very, very sorry to hear that. Well, hopefully if you poke around on the internet, you can find, like, some kind of place to crash for a bit until you get on your feet. I love Quake. It was one of those first retro FPSs I ever played when I got my own PC. I came in at Quake 2. Yeah! And I was not computer savvy enough to get Quake running properly. Like, Quake was kind of before, like, 3DFX Glide and a bunch of kind of earlier, more contained 3D acceleration technologies. So, like, I could get it running in software mode. Like, that wasn't that hard, but the game is not... I mean, I guess it's still there, but I was still getting used to first-person shooters with, like, a mouse and keyboard and stuff, so I never played it as much as I should have, given how formative it is and how, like, important it is to all of the games that I love now. It is pretty, it's like you gotta read your classics. Yeah! Bought a Diamond Voodoo 1 for this game? Yeah. One of those wacky ones where it had to do, like, a video bypass. The 3D card actually had no hardware to render anything two-dimensional, so you had to pair it with your 2D video card. That's when, like, some of that spirit came back with, like, SLI, but jeez. That had an external pass-through. I went to this is a very dated statement, but one of the first LAN parties I went to, I did not bring my, like, video card cable, that tiny little guy, so I couldn't even use my 3D card at all. I had to play Quake 2 in software mode. Man, this audio is sick, though. I was unemployed for several months at the beginning of the year, timing between tax returns and stimulus checks kept me alive. Pure luck. Haven't gotten a penny from unemployment. Sucks to hear, but stay strong. Ugh. Yeah, it sounds like you've been going through it too. What's the process of running a PC game for the first time like back in the day? It depends which day. If it's DOS, you need to read the book. Like, you have to read the manual to get some installation instructions. Sometimes it required, like, installing a specific driver or booting your computer in a specific way with a specific, like, startup script to get the resources you needed to. Not good stuff. Windows was like, I don't know, Windows was like install it, uninstall it, install it again, uninstall it again. And like each time you sort of try different stuff, pick different configuration options. I guess that's the rough part is that games needed to be manually configured according to what hardware you had. You had to tell it what you had, and you had to be right. And sometimes you didn't know, or it didn't support exactly what you had, but something else might. Or if you, like, installed this one series of drivers that accidentally supported it, so now you gotta find that. Ugh. Spend, like, 2 hours downloading patches over dial-up. Was DOS before Windows? Yeah. Loud. It's loud for me too, so I think it's supposed to be loud in here. Ow, ow! I just gave up. I was like, I wasn't gonna go for it. That was a bad idea. Imagine the responsive gamers had to read a book in order to install a game nowadays. Yeah, I'm not gonna say that it was, like, good that it was like that. Or that it was, you know, great for the medium or whatever. But, it did change the tone of everything. Game developers, especially in the PC scene, could assume that the players would be willing to, like, stop and learn and kind of come to the game instead of the game coming to them. And that created different kinds of games. Not necessarily, like, better ones, maybe in some cases, but certainly more unique experiences. But now it's like you've got to have a very particular control template. You've got to present your game in a very particular kind of way. There's just no wild, the absolute most Wild West feels like it was the PC scene in the 90s. You could do anything, especially when, like, CD-ROMs started hitting. Man, it was crazy. People just came up with all sorts of ideas and just did them. Digital Foundry did a retrospective on Quake, revolutionized the GPU market. God. That's like a whole other level of genius. You're that good at coding that you kickstart, like, a whole hardware... Ow! Whole hardware economy. I mean, somebody would have done it eventually, right? But still. Hey, Kimmy. Quake's 25? Well, I'm 21, so take that. Ooh. There are people in this chat who have always lived with Quake. As it was intended. Civilization really began when Quake came out. Yeah, BQ and AQ. That's why they call it that. Turns out the Q stands for Quake. Has anyone heard the story of John Carmack being a literal juvenile delinquent criminal mastermind? Yeah. He just, like, apparently was just a... It's good that he found the path of good. But yeah, he could be a hell of a Bond villain if he wanted to be. Instead, he just likes flying rockets. Yeah, apparently he vandalized quite a bit when he was in high school. Like, the kind of thing you'd have an 80s movie about. Kid genius. Running shit. He stole computers from his high school to learn to code. I mean, yeah, but that's like... That's awesome, though. So yeah, I kind of came into shooters on Quake 2, so I have some learning to do. I didn't even really play the first-person DOS sort of action RPG games very much. Ultima Underworld and Eye of the Beholder and stuff like that. I played those a little bit. Or what was it? Westwood made one too. These are the proto Demon Souls kind of games. Just a weird, quirky, fantasy, hardcore RPG. You gotta figure out what to do, because they're not gonna tell you. I'm 4 years and 8 days younger than Quake. They call them boomer shooters for a reason. Zoomer shooters at? I mean, I guess a zoomer shooter would be Fortnite. They're there. Zoomer shooters are the most popular shooters in the world. Yeah, Splatoon? Halo's a millennial shooter. Three? Oh. Hey! Jeez. Slime Rancher is the only zoomer shooter. The computer couldn't handle it for a second there. CPU must be overheating. Spitting out all those fumes. Stay down? I actually don't know. They just always get back up? Damn, they're getting me though. Making this hallway uncomfortable. Okay. Oh, he's not dead. There's another one. Damn. Oh, you gotta explode them. Okay. That makes total sense. Look at that. They even showed it to you right there. Birthday Quake? Yeah. Wait, you remember reading the Quake manual? About the zombies? Thou can't kill that which doth live, but you can blow them into chunky giblets or something to that effect. Yeah, that sounds about like the same weirdly, childlike revelatory tone a lot of its software games seem to have. Trying not to be a downer? No. Volcor, glad to be here. Yeah, please, do not worry about being a downer or whatever. The thing that I honestly enjoy, and I would actually be upset if it went away, is just hearing how people's lives are going, what they're up to. So, never feel like what you're going through is an inconvenience for somebody else. That's why I'm here, quite literally, I think. He's shambling. Quake DM multiplayer into the wee late nights. So PC Gamer is actually running a Quake server this week in honor of Quake's 25th. You just have to, like, if you own Quake, and I think it's like $5 on Steam. They even have an article about the distro that is really easy to play with. I'm thinking about trying to get in there. Maybe not today. It was, I have some other plans tonight, and I was running low on time already. I had to, as I was opining previously, had to reinstall Windows on my stream PC. Can you believe, hold on a second, I gotta moderate quickly. There we are. Can you believe that I, in the year of, in post-Quake 25, PQ25, had a Windows install where the system partition was on another drive? Can you believe it? Basically, I have a solid state for my Windows, and then I have a... Oh, no, 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 gamer, don't worry about that. It was actually Honkies that got that auto-modded, but it's cool. We had a Quake 2 clan called PPH Pipe Hitting Honkies. Smoked a lot of pot back in my younger days. That sounds chill. Like, why would you have a problem with them? Playing some Quake, getting ripped. Hey, it's Tuesday too, so it's fine for that. Oh, Van. Love you, Lawdog. Life's been really hard for me lately with bad health problems and severe family problems. Your streams bring me joy where there isn't much for me. Blow things into chunky giblets. Giblets. Thank you so much for all you do. Well, thank you, Van. And I'm sorry you're going through some rough stuff. Let your stresses go away. Pretend your stresses are these weird little Cthulhu snake dudes and that they're getting blasted with a big old shotgun. Anyway, oh yeah, right. So, I discovered that I wasn't able to, like, search through metadata of my MediaTek clips anymore. Windows Explorer just wasn't doing it, and I was like, well, maybe it's because it's over the network, because I edit them to my gaming PC and not, so it's not local to the OBS instance anyway. I was like, okay, I'll just swap the hard drive. But lo and behold, when I took my physical drive out, Windows wouldn't boot. So somewhere during installation, it put all the boot tables on the other hard drive, and I don't know why or when or whatever the... Anyway, OBS loads a lot faster now, so that's cool. It was starting to take a long time. Never listened to a Quakecast on the pseudo network. Can't say that I have, no. I've watched a lot of Quake esports. They like do Quake Champions every Sunday now. It's great. I'll watch that with like my Sunday breakfast, drinking coffee. Hey. Ooh! Got caught slipping so bad. It's pretty wild that, like, I love that for the first, you know, the first fully 3D game, they super went for it. I'm like, no, it's gonna be fast. It's gonna be fast and crazy, and there's gonna be monsters and laser bolts and... Like, whoa, shouldn't we, like, make a racing game? No! No, we should not! Shotguns. I think it was through here. I need to find my way back to that. Wait a minute. Was it? Hold on a minute. Wait. I don't think it's... Also, I guess Quake kicked off the brown and green era of shooters, and it lasted a long time. Where the... Is it through here? it is through here. Whoops. Proof that the games that we really want are the ones where we just shoot shit. I mean, I think that's true. I think people respond to immediacy. People respond to action. My friend used to work at a bar. We used to hold parties on the bar he worked at. Once my computer overheated, so we threw it in the freezer with a beer. With the beer. That's amazing. Man, tales of the tech age. Must have grazed the T button. I remember playing Quake. Oh man, yeah. Did the stereotypical like hijacking the computer lab. I remember playing Quake in there a lot. I say a lot. It was like one day, and it was the most beautiful day. Man, who could have known that exact activity would actually be a job in the future? Yeah, you were there, weren't you, Fairy King? Keep doing that. Although it is pretty sick that the game like pauses. Hey, what's up, Pop-Tart? Hope you're all doing well. Love your cute shark, by the way, and the octopus you got on the wall. Yeah, Steph is an aquatic connoisseur. She has excellent taste when it comes to things in the ocean. Probably the hard way to do that. Can I hop up this stuff? Where? Yeah, I'm excited to see what the level design of this game or this campaign ends up being. This Quake 2 actually was, I went back and played it when it did the RTX thing and I was kind of impressed. It has like almost pseudo open world level design sometimes. You have to like go to one place and backtrack through other areas you've been to. There's kind of a function to the levels. It's not just get to the exit. It's like the exit is a thing that is kind of important for a three-line story. Oh, I'm gonna get squished. No, don't squish. No squish. I almost got squished. Quake 2 had a hub world? Sort of. There were a couple of hub areas you would move through. Wait, Trent did all the voices? So any damage you take, it's Trent. It's him going, "Hurr!" Oh, damn! Ah, shoot, I was not paying attention. Wait a minute, this is the last level. Did I just do that? Shit. I gotta save. Oh, come on. Man, I don't even have the key yet. Oh boy. Alright, let's kick this into overdrive. Oops. That's not overdrive. That's not over... Trapped me. Bind quick save. That seems like an important thing to do. Nah, who needs it? You know? There's one in it. Okay, there we go. Quake Champions bundle is 50% off. Well, what a deal! Someone who loves rooting and shooting. Ow! Quake One goes places. All right. I'm mostly just used to this, you know, green and brown, spooky enemies, Cthulhu stuff. We play Quake Champions every day. Nice. It is an educated game for educated gamers. All right. Oh yeah. Quick save. Bang. So am I. Doesn't mean anything. I guess you're right. Imagine spending your life not playing Quake. Ooh. We have abandoned underwater houses. Long forgotten relics. Ancient ruins. Aha! Oh, hey, Turbid! What is up? Thank you for the resub. Hope everything's good with you. God, this audio is pretty wild. It's very intense. It's always like... It does remind me of how, like, a lot of albums were starting to be mastered at the time. Sort of blown out wall of sound, sort of... brick, like a waveform that's just a brick. Half-Life 1 have a multiplayer. Yes, and it was great. It was, the weaponry was like a weird mix of like bullet hitscan guns and then creepy, like weird, quakey science guns. Yeah, they even share tech. Half-Life is basically Quake 2. And Half-Life 1 multiplayer scene was pretty sick. Because since it was basically Quake, it was pretty mod-friendly. I remember, like, in the heyday of Quake 2 and then Half-Life, there'd be, like, basically a new mod every week, just some new kind of gameplay mode. Join some random server with 400 ping and just try it out. I imagine that's probably what it's like poking around different Minecraft servers or something like that now. Half-Life 2 also have multiplayer? It did! Actually, Half-Life 2 multiplayer was really good, too. It was like a kind of a slower paced, but still, like, kind of weighty and interesting deathmatch. And you could, like, shoot toilets at people and, like, conk them out. It was really cool. I think I already hit that. I really enjoyed Half-Life 2 deathmatch. It didn't really catch though. That's the first like multiplayer mode of a popular shooter I remember that just didn't really go. People just didn't seem to care much for it at that point. I get it, like deathmatch was kind of passé. Or free for all. Okay, I have a key now. Where does that key go? Hey, what's up, Rubber? Half-Life 2's gunplay was not its strong suit. Yeah, I didn't think it was bad. It was like, it was more cinematic, though. I guess that's how I'd describe it. Cinematic gunplay. Man, yeah, this music is great. Missed out on a lot by it, not me. Oh! Okay. Blaster in the past, remember playing this when I was 5? Oh, that's awesome. Do you remember the secret level here? No. I am not very familiar with the Quake single player campaign at all. I did also buy the mission packs. But Lord knows I probably won't finish it. Still, it's good to be prepared. Played Quake 64 before the PC version? I remember renting that. I bizarrely didn't play that as much as I played Doom 64. I don't want a backseat. This is more like a tourist playthrough, given that it's been out for so long. Ow! I guess if there's, something that's, like, super significant, like Easter egg or something like that, I'd be interested to know that. But if it's just, like, armor or something like that, I mean, whatever. I could take or leave that. I mean, just now learning Turok is a ripoff of this? I mean, kinda? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, Turok had, like, the big levels. Jesus. I got roughed up. Hey. I gotta crawl into this hole now. Turok was pretty rad. It was like the kind of big, somber, run around in solitude and shoot a bunch of enemies shooter that wasn't quite really on consoles at that point. And didn't really find much of a place either, it seems like. Shadows of the Empire was kind of like that too. I like that game. I like the big, kind of empty games. Oh, okay, I have to crawl up and around. No! No! Oh. A secret cave has opened. Damn it! I jumped right in it again! Oh, why did I do that? Okay. First time you're here, hello? Well, hello, Oni. Hello and welcome. I gotta admit, I'm in a weird frame of mind today. I was kind of scrambling, doing some tech stuff, so... But you know what? I'm playing Quake now. Everything's fine. I have a lot to look forward to. I changed my stream frame rate to 59.94 instead of 60. I don't know. Do you guys feel like it is buttery smooth? Are you guys seeing butter? I hope you're seeing butter. And my preliminary test seemed pretty buttery. Seeing the nail gun? Alright. Seeing butter, but I'm also really hungry. Shit! Shit! No! Ow! Oh, my ankle. Stream quality's been fantastic. Good to know. Okay. I did sort of take the chance of basically reconfiguring everything to make sure that all my settings were sort of set properly up and down the line. All my drivers were tweaked to perfection. I'll check the recording later, but there's really no way to get feedback on it aside from just watching the stream. Stream VOD's been pretty good for that too, checking that. Oh, okay, there we go. I guess I didn't get the cave. I probably should have backtracked to the beginning. I'm surprised you took the filter off your camera. I took the filter off part of it. It's still on the edges a little bit. But yeah, I'm tweaking a... Ow! Uh-oh. Figure why make it harder to see the moneymaker, you know? Gazing upon this beautiful mug is but one of the many services I provide. Shouldn't make it harder. I have to do like 5 test recordings before I stream just to... Oh. Quell the tech anxiety? I did one. I'm trying to live more in the moment. Make people pay for face cam? Yeah, sub only for face cam. Man, could you imagine? So here's... I'm kind of surprised it hasn't gotten here yet. Where you can send like a Twitch... A video stream that has, like, video layers in it. And then you can, like, charge access for different video layers. So, yeah, if you want to turn on the face cam, you, like, pay for a different level of sub membership or something like that. Oh, frick. To be honest, there are some... Oh, man, that really hurt. There are some, like... There are some times that... I kind of wish that I could choose, like, the audio that I'm listening to and stuff like that. Don't give them ideas. It'd be pretty sick though, wouldn't it? Imagine you could customize your stream. So let's say there's a vision of this where like you don't pay anything extra. The price only goes down if you don't want video there. Let's say it's like that. It may not be like that, probably wouldn't be like that, but let's just say it would be. What if you could pay for a cheaper stream or a cheaper sub and only get the like gameplay and audio or something like that? Or what if you could just not get the gameplay at all? How do I get the giveaway? I haven't done it yet. I'll post up and do it in a minute here. Also, Kinatar, it's good to see you. Hot tub stream, but you're playing an obscure FPS. Where's my hot tub? I think it would be neat to stream multiple audio channels so that you could customize the audio mix on your side if you wanted to. I think that'd be neat. So like if you want more of people talking and less game, you can set it that way. If you just want to hear the game, you can set it that way. That seems like a neat thing to do. Just watch your RE2 playthrough. Big fan. Thanks for the content. Oh, I'm glad you enjoyed it. That game was great. Oh, man, I love that game. Makes me want to finish my... you reminded me. I didn't finish my RE8 Village of Shadows playthrough. Ooh, ooh. angry monkey man. Oh, the remake? Yeah, I haven't played like PS1 and RE2 in a while. You're playing Alan Wake for 360? Yeah, love that game. I'm excited what they're doing with how they're working Alan Wake into control. Very excited to see all that. The BOS is so hard without infinite ammo. It was okay so far from what I had played, but I guess I didn't really get that far. I beat Lady Domitresque. So it was like Dollhouse next. I was doing some like village stuff and then going to the Dollhouse. Like Dollhouse is no combat. Actually, Fishman is not really combat either. It's pretty wild. Out of like the four lands and village, two of them are not even really combat intense. My sin gameplay while you do squats for subs in a hot tub. God, that would be it, right? The ultimate sellout stream. I'm just screaming like catchphrases that James came up with while I'm doing squats in a hot tub. Give me money, Blade. I'll get there one day. Twitch is just a long, slow march of trading away your dignity bit by bit every day. Oh! Until I'm like shotgunning pickle brine live on stream. Would pay for that show? Hell yeah, you would. It's always nice to have a $1 million idea in your back pocket. Oh, Katie! Hey, oh my gosh, I totally missed that, I'm sorry. Thank you very much for the resub. I hope life is great with you. I'm sorry that you had to wait. Okay, I have a key now. I can't remember which side the key was on though. Must have been on the other one, I think. Meek Shonos, thank you very much for the Prime. Ooh, and Jatsy Joe, thanks for gifting a sub to Volcor. That's super nice of you. I think I actually missed a few here. Oh. It That Consumes, hello. First time watching, really appreciating everything you've done in the past few years. Big fan. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Ow! 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 Oh, they're so mean! That was pretty great. Ow. Yes, I mean, sometimes I'll have like a day where I stream and I stop streaming and I'm like, ah, I played video games today. And then I'm like, man, it feels like I'm not doing a whole lot aside from that. But I actually kind of am. It's weird to remind myself of that. Oh yeah, we should have an Inside Game special report going up pretty soon here. I think we're just a teensy bit late on catching the wave, but we did a special report on Blue Box Games. Oh crap. And for the hot tub stream, I'm playing Sonic Boom. I still need to play Sonic Boom, you're right. I've owed that for a long time. Oh, I gotta dig out my Wii U. I get to dig out my Wii. Spend a whole day with Sonic. And the Rise of Lyric team. All my new friends. I'm gonna get back to doing 24-hour streams more, I think. Probably doing tie-ins with G Fuel, actually. It's kind of a perfect sponsorship. Oh!
Hmm.
Come on. Oh, no. Crap. More 24-hour roulette streams? Yeah, I need to do more of those. Those are really fun. And what a great way to, like, just get a nonstop parade of weird and interesting games. Yeah, DS Roulette is kind of a shoo-in for the next one. How far back am I? Am I actually quicksaving when I hit this button? Yeah, huh. Yeah, maybe I'm not quick loading. Is it F9? Yeah, okay. So wait, when you die, does it quick load? Or does it... I guess I don't know. I was just mashing buttons. I'll pay more attention next time. Yeah, I just overrode it. So I guess it's your last manual save is what it throws you back to? It does that thing? Okay, to the start of the level. Alright. Oh my gosh, I'm like multiple stages back. God. So wait, why did the load go there? That must have been a manual load. Or a manual save, yeah. Okay, so the quick save doesn't even show up in the load list. You have to use the button. Got it. Oh goodness. Okay, I am several stages back. Maybe just one stage. It still hurts though. Oh well, it's my own dumb fault. Like a child with a weapon, I can't be trusted. Flying through menus and smashing all sorts of things without even thinking. Ow! Oh my gosh, yeah, this level. Well, I guess I'm really good at it by now. Okay, so. Yeah, you can't really run through them. Your hitbox is your little, what is he, ranger? He's a little chunky little guy. He's got wide hips. He gets clipped pretty easily. I can look for the secret cave now. That's exactly why I did this. Jesus. Oh! Man, I'm so glad you guys are on my wavelength sometimes. Like, I don't even have to say it, and you understand that I did it on purpose. For a smart reason and not a dumb one. Hey! Gun is really strong. I'm gonna have to use that. Oh, come on. Come on, guy. Hey, buddy, come on. Okay, I'm gonna remember. I'm gonna hit the button right. You mean you should use the super nail gun instead of just the nail gun? There's probably some reason to use the regular nail gun, right? Is there some enemy that the super nail gun is inefficient for? Actually, probably not. It uses the same kind of ammo, just better. I mean more like, whip that out when there's a lot of enemies to burn down. Okay, no? Once you have the super nail gun, it's just better. You get more kill per kill. That's the only rating system I care about. Kills per kills. Kills harder. Kill them more. The normal gun kills in a normal way. The super gun kills in a super way. There. Hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. Last I'll say in advice from the Quake 1 manual itself. Shamblers. Even other monsters fear him, so expect a clobbering. He shrugs off explosions. Okay. That's a valuable gameplay tip plus lore thing. I'm completely out of ammo. What the? The shit? Shit. God damn it. Super nail gun is twice as strong, shoots just as fast, and the projectiles fly about 50% faster. Oh, well. That's a weird game design decision then. Okay. God, it's like the perfect thing for him to shoot me in. I didn't know they'd fight each other. That's cute. Is this potentially what opens the secret cave? Secret cave. I'm gonna backtrack a little bit. This seems like this is a place that might have a cave. I see no secret cave though. Well then. Oh yeah, there was this. Oh, that's conspicuous. Oh, I don't know where this is gonna go. What the? Did this just like warp to the end of Act 1? Oh, you got to this level you were on before loading after this. Oh, okay. Got it. Alright, so this is just like a secret level. Tough jump. If that's what they want me to do. Okay, so you do have some air control. Okay, so I can just jump straight up and then scrape over. I think that should work. Before your tactical load. Oh, I see what you mean. That load. Got it. Okay. Fall off. Can't be showing tactical loads on Twitch. You're right. It is a very newbie thing to do, isn't it? I gotta, like, cough or misdirect or something. Just be like, what's that? Hey, chat, what's that? Jeez. Gafgarian, thank you for the sub. Not too far off hot tub streams? What do you mean? Quake? Quake is just... it's that much of a draw now? I mean, I've been waiting for this moment. Oh, I need to push that, I bet. You DSP'd it. I mean, doing the full DSP would then be blaming the game, right? I'm at least owning that one. Sounds very spooky. What the? Back down? Why is it so hot? What part of, where are you right now? Yeah, there's like a heat dome across the whole nation, right? Seeing people on the timeline start to sweat it out. Oh, there's an elevator. Gosh. Alright, well. Okay. Huh. quite know. I guess you have to be able to break line of sight with these guys. Otherwise, they're just gonna hit you. And I guess they telegraph when they give you the sparkle hands. Man, all these particles. Yeah, the lighting? Oh, man. This audio design is really good. It's actually adding a lot to the atmosphere. Oh, Ryan Peters, thanks for the sub as well. I missed that a bit ago. Sorry about that. Hey, what's up, Holy Frax? How you doing? I'm quaking. Huh. Just chilling with my boy, Trent. Love the lava texture. Yeah. I'm trying to think of, like, the most recent game that had this sort of, like, gothic aesthetic. I mean, parts of Doom were kind of approaching this. Especially in Eternal. They mentioned slipgates in one of the lore entries, and I was like, oh, no, Quake! Amnesia gets pretty gothic? Yeah, maybe it is Amnesia. Call of Cthulhu. There was that one Cthulhu game that came out pretty recently. The one in the desert? Yeah. Yes, that one. I'm blanking on the name a bit. You're getting DMCA, I don't hear any music. The soundtrack of this game isn't really music. It's more like ominous tones. It's that wham in the background. Amnesia Rebirth, that's the one. Yeah. Mentioning Amnesia made me think of that one. Still Amnesia, I guess. Katarina, thank you for the raid. And welcome all raiders. I'm playing Quake because it's the Quake 25th anniversary today. And I have a couple of games, courtesy of Good Old Games, that I'll be giving away later. I can only stream for about another hour, because I have some existing plans. Just gonna meet up with some friends. Have some good old times. In the meantime... spooky Quake times. So I got the key. Where was the door? Where was that door? There it is. Did know Good Old Games did affiliate programs? It's actually a pretty new thing. As of like last month is kind of when they started launching it, so... I've been a huge fan of Good Old Games for a long time. They already had a creator program where they would basically give you game codes in exchange for representation on the stream. But now it's expanding into a... Okay. Zero Secrets. That was a fun level. And, okay, I remember that sky. Quick save. And now they're kind of expanding it to a referral affiliate program. But as part of that... they're giving all their affiliates a ton of free games to give away. So, I got some free games to give away. Do a regular save in case you mess up. That is excellent advice. There we go. But, I think it all worked out in the long run. Actually, hold on a second. Let me... Oh, you can't rebind the guns? I bet you could do it through, like, a text file or something. I like the way Epic do it with a creator code. Did you ever get one? Not for Epic. No, I should, though. I should sign up for one. There's no reason I haven't. I just keep forgetting to. People have asked, too. That's an Epic paycheck I'm leaving on the table. That's not smart. But, Antillian, I'm glad we agree. Yes, Good Old Games is awesome. Oops. Guns are guns. 7 is rocket launcher, 6 grenade, 4 and 5 nail, forever and ever. Interesting. I remember trying to bind guns like they were bound in Quake 2. Because I was just kind of used to that for a long time. I would have been even more stuck like that if I had played a lot of Quake, given that you can't rebind them at all. Game still has your favorite art design of any id Software game? I could understand that. They didn't really make another game that sort of closed in on this. Those guys take 2 rockets to kill, and they drop 2 rockets when they die. I guess if you play efficiently, you could, like, be ammo neutral for most of the game. Ah! Dang it! Eh. Yeah, blessed mammal, I am not playing Doom, believe it or not. I mean, it's same wheelhouse, though. Oh, Mystios Thumper, thank you very much for the resub. Morning from the UK, been busy setting into the new home, but loving it. Happy to have caught you live. Well, I'm happy to be able to wish you a merry homecoming. Homewarming, housewarming. Well, shouldn't it be homewarming anyway? Congratulations on the new place. It looks great. Let me look around a little bit. Ah, nice. Nice tall ceilings you got here. That's good stuff. Plenty of room for art on the wall? Did I do the secret level? I did. It was cool. This gun was the rocket launcher. It's just so much better than the Doom rocket launcher was. It's really good. I guess I didn't play enough classic Doom to really understand the relative value of the rocket launcher there. It was pretty good for getting, like, it was the only AoE weapon, right? What's up, Full Metal Ninja? I guess the thing with it in Doom was, is that it could kill you. Be very careful about when and how you decided to shoot it. Oh, that's true. BFG. Yeah. Forgot about that guy.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm now officially, I think, past where I got before, because that's the place that killed me, and then I reloaded, and then it all went bad. So... I am now further in Quake than I've ever been. Oh, you like my shirt? Thank you, Illmatic. I was feeling some hot colors today. I was feeling some vibrancy. Spoilers on how to get secrets? I mean, if they're really cool, important, neat, big time, rad, worth seeing secrets, then sure. I don't care. I am not that protective of this particular playthrough. Even though it is technically my first. Is this permadeath? No. I am playing on hard, though. Oh, you. See, that's the sort of thing you would have to, like, know. Although, Cams, that was a well-timed question. Jeez. Look at him just staring at me when I'm dead. Stupid faces. Ever moral stance on clones in indie gaming. Huh. I haven't thought about it much, but it does, now that I've kind of mulled it over in the old noggin, it does seem like a pretty complicated topic. I mean, I guess at some point it just has to be like copyright law, where you draw the boundaries, right? It's not great, but how do you stop it? Like, it's people's right to do that, right? Kind of, maybe? Who decides what is an earnest attempt and what isn't at making something original? All right. Got your number, stupid zombie demon guys. Oh no! Oh, okay. Okay then. Wait, what's this? Oh, it just dumps you back here. Okay. Ow. I don't mind if Twitch runs ads, just mix it up a little. I wish that I could see the ads that get run on my channel, but I have Twitch Turbo, so I never do. Also, it's my channel, so. And I turned off ads for subs. A lot of the times I'm just ignorant about the kinds of ads that get shown on Twitch. There are ads on this channel? I mean, there might be. You're a VIP, so you'll never see one. So many whispers. Oh, that's what I was flexing. Nice. Well, that was an alley-oop then. Remove his VIP for being smug. Yeah, that's the... The one hidden rule, any ounce of smugness and your VIP is revoked. It's actually so I can get, like, fractions of a penny off of your ad views. I remember this stage. Remember these cool little wire diagrams over lava. It's really neat. Jesus Christ.
Oh.
It like drops you down multiple levels. Hey, what's up, real big hot dog? Oh, they are all around me. Not entirely sure what the goal of this hallway is. I might have to try a few times to find out. I assume VIP slots are full now. No, they are not. You just have to save up enough channel points and then redeem a VIP or ban. And then you have a 50-50 shot at getting VIP. It's that simple. I don't have it activated right now, though, because I don't have the script set up. Yes, the option is gone. You're right. Because, like I said, I just reinstalled OBS. So none of that stuff is set up. It's not the most complicated, but there is like a script that I have to basically reinstall and rewrite. Oh, crap. I think I have to rewrite the script. Whatever. I largely remember what I was doing. G.I. Jose, miss me playing with Funhouse? Yeah, I know, I understand. But, sometimes I play with Bruce here. So that happens. Sometimes I play with other people too. But, I will say that this stream is not quite going for the same vibe as Funhouse content, so. Can't quite be a perfect replacement. Sounds like you should get your OBS scripts into GitHub or something like that. Yeah, normally I back them up. This was a very unexpected storage fault. I mean, I don't know how to describe it. It was something that was going to have to happen anyway, and had I backed things up properly, it would have been a little smoother, but this gives me an opportunity. I was actually kind of looking forward to rebuilding everything because I just need to organize things a lot better. I would like add one thing to my stream over time, like just kind of bolt it up, and it got pretty unwieldy and pretty disorganized, so this is okay, but I just have to reinstall a scripting utility and then reset up some scripts. Shouldn't be that bad. Speaking of testing things and redoing things, I'm gonna take a break. I'm gonna use the restroom. Let's see if this works properly. I'll be back soon. Oh, wow. I was gonna say, everything worked, and then my throat did not. I got myself a nice soda. I'm gonna crack this cold one open. Ah, just because that's such a good feeling. Did the VIP or bans recently? How'd they do that? Yeah, we've had a streak of VIPs lately. Indeed we have, alright. Let's get back to exploring the arcane realms. That was fast. And so ends the tale of Arcane Explorer. Damn. Alright, bridge activated. Such a good teleport sound. God damn it, everything! Everything summons monsters! Ow! Crap. I've been shambled. That's mean. Are they just throwing at you? And you're all the way down that hallway? Man. Oh, the 24 hours of media tech? That is a serious deal, right? That'll happen someday. Fuck. What? Oh, right. Ow. He's trying to kite him. Oh, Jesus. Hold on, maybe. Yes! I can make this work for me. What? The hell? Oh, I fell in lava. They didn't even do... Couldn't even do me the solid of having me telefrag him. Jeez. He knew he was waiting for me. There. Golly. Spooky looking door. You got Terminator 2'd? Yeah. Yeah. I guess technically I did do it to myself too. I've seen it from quite a few things this month. Sucks, but I want to appreciate my grass and my booze. Yeah, you're just trying to reset everything. Pearl Rockstar, thank you for the prime. Hey, what's going on, Pearl? Ooh! It's spooky in there. Guess what? It's a shambler. Oh, I'm annoyed I wasted that much ammo on him. Okay. This is like the first boss, right? There's a creepy thing going on here. What's this all about? Oh! He's got demon abs! I think this boss is like stage interaction. I remember killing this guy. But I think you have to like hit some switches and then electrocute him or something. Maybe that happens after you shoot him enough. Oof. Oof. You've got the rune! Yeah. This. Okay. Yeah. Do that. It lowers it. This lowers that one. Then you give him the sparks. I guess you just gotta keep doing that. I don't know if shooting him matters. Shock his nipples. I feel like Satan would get power from that. I did not know Quake sounded like this. I'm waiting for all the text to come up so we can get our lore properly. As the corpse of the monstrous entity Cathod slips back into the lava whence it rose, you grip the rune of earth magic tightly. Now that you have conquered the dimension of the doomed realm of earth magic, you are ready to complete your task. A rune of magic power lies at the end of each haunted land of Quake. Go forth, Seekent. Seek the totality of the four runes. You got it. I crave totality. That means I'm done there. All right. Ooh. The realm of black magic. Ancient castles and strange beasts ahead. Tiny texts, yeah. I think I could scale it up. Ooh, the netherworld. Primal fear in a strange dimension. Quake had the Strog. That was Quake 2 and 4. Quake 1 is about, like, this stuff. It's a weird... Yeah, what is that? Oh, like maybe back there? Okay. I feel it in the floor. The Elder World! Your worst nightmares come true. Alright, I'm gonna go into the realm of black magic. That doesn't look like black magic. Looks like cyber magic. Are you guys black magicians? Better not be doing magic in here. Techno magic canister cop, thank you for the prime. I mean, luckily a low thrumming engine really does match with this game, so I ain't mad. Oh, we got thick boys now. They took their dark magic pills. Grew up big and strong. RTX God mode? Not quite, no. That doesn't exist for Quake 1. I mean, it kind of does. I did see some community-sourced RTX mods or ray traced mods. But they kind of, like, you had to recompile them on your own, and I didn't have, like, a dev environment set up. Some of them might just be ready for modding, but I just kind of wanted to play Quake. Also, I bashed my head against enough technical issues this morning. The good news is that I'm on the tail end of them. MediaTek should be a lot more interesting now. Now that I can, like, I have a local folder with all that media in it that can be indexed by Windows, I think I'll be able to do a lot more. Be able to, like, switch playlists much, much faster, so I can be a lot more granular with them. Like, right now, when I want to pick a category or a playlist, I feel like I have to make something that's, like, at least 20 or 30 minutes long. Otherwise, it's not going to be worth the time spent to switch and generate the playlist and stuff like that. Play Quake 2 RTX. I have, yeah. I really enjoy it. It's fun. Quake 2 is an interesting game, too. It's surprisingly aggressive with some of its design. More interesting, more wood. Yeah, I mean, there's always more George Wood. I have a whole lot of George Wood to convert and edit into clips. He made a lot of stuff. He talked a lot. He was doing the content creation grind before that was a thing. Convert that wood, oh yes. You pull from your own media server or just have 2 terabytes of those commercials on one drive? It's that on one drive, yeah. It's not 2 terabytes though, it's shockingly small. All of the media that I've converted, I've re-encoded. So it's really efficient. And a lot of this media is like barely even 1080p. So the media files are pretty tiny. Old media compresses up real nice. Where the hell? Hold on. Somewhere I need to go that I'm not going. Damn, well, I'm finding a lot of secrets. But, yeah, that cough was unpleasant. It was very gargly. Previously, I would edit out the clips and they'd sit on my main PC, my gaming PC. And then my streaming PC would read those files across a network. And then I could use metadata on those files to sort of subsort them. Or make playlists of particular... Oh, it was right there. Particular sets of files. But it took a long time to run that search query across the network. And then it just stopped working entirely. It just would not let me query by tag anymore. So I was like, okay, time to move it and make it local. But then it turns out... And I have told the story before, and it probably makes sense only to me, but... The storage drive I was using on my streaming PC... had, like, the system partition on it for some reason. So when I took it out, my PC wouldn't boot. So I wanted to swap out my storage hard drive so that I could move all my clips over. But then Windows wouldn't boot without it! I tried unsuccessfully to move the partition, and then my computer just wouldn't boot at all. So... That was my day. But... Back up and running. OBS doesn't take a really long time to launch anymore. Alright, I have a blue key now. And hopefully, I'm gonna check out the capture after the stream. Hopefully it's more buttery smooth than ever. I mean, of any game, if any game's gonna be buttery smooth, it ought to be Quake 1. Whoa! Pass my security plus. Yes, Thrill Mo, awesome. I'm on my way to Hacker Man status. Until he did that with a replacement SSD, had no idea GPT boot partition was sitting on one of the spares. Yeah, how does it get there? Do you just like, do you whoopsie and hit the wrong button? When you're installing Windows or something? Sometimes I feel like it, when Windows installer boots up, it just picks a drive and makes a backup partition right away. And then it's just there. Looks pretty silky, all right. Good to know. I'm hoping it's as silky with other games. I'm always in pursuit of the silk. I believe pretty firmly that if you have a properly set up buttery smooth 60 FPS stream, that it's just more pleasant to look at, like, in an immediate glance than a gameplay stream where the gameplay window is, like, skipping frames or juddering. That's what I think. It is my hidden strategy that getting your AV all tightened up is the secret sauce to being popular on Twitch. Exactly. People can't look away from those epic FPS. That outrageous stream quality. Just can't look away. Look at all that lighting! I didn't know that Quake 1 actually had guns with dynamic lights. Alright, fine. Oh, they were just the wall. Okay. Gonna be cool when 120 FPS is the new normal. Yeah, I think what's gonna be interesting is they see usage stats about this stuff, you know? There are some TVs that support 120 Hz, so they can see who's using it and, like, for the players that have a choice, what are they choosing to use? So it'll be interesting to see it, like, if 120 Hz becomes, like, the thing people are gravitating towards, and then more and more games choose to try to support it. That would be very cool. Light E3 is over because no one has been, like, streaming at 900p? I mean, the reason that happens, though, is because they're new. And that's a good thing for me. But yes, I understand. It is an odd resolution. It is an odd resolution to stream at. Norms Brew, thanks for the sub. Oh. Cool. I think it came down to the SSD used to be a main C drive, so when I imaged my new NVMe, removed the old SSD, it wouldn't boot. Put the SSD back on and Windows booted. Then it changed it to NVMe after. Yeah, you can change the, like, boot sector, and I thought I made my drive bootable, but it was just gone. Oh, I don't mind people asking about 900p. They just got real fucking pissy about it after we kindly explained. Oh. Now that's not okay. I'm sorry about that. I didn't know that. I actually missed that happening. I don't understand what's there to be pissy about. It's a pretty straightforward concept. I guess people find a way. Oh, okay. There's like some weird... It's like a weird droning in the background. It's like piano? Yeah, it's like electronically distorted piano kind of warbling around back there. Yeah, Flitz, this is the Trent Reznor soundtrack for Quake. It almost sounds like it's playing multiple audio tracks, like kind of fading in and out over each other. But I'm pretty sure it was just an audio CD soundtrack. Oh, what's the reason for 900p? Ah! For my CPU, I found that I could not reliably get 60 FPS at 1080p at a certain like encoding preset. I had to put it down pretty far before it would start dipping frames. And this was like for really fast-paced flickering kind of games. I remember flying around in Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is actually what became my like encoding test. But I found I got way better image quality in general, especially in motion, out of downscaling my video output to 900p instead of 1080p, and then using a higher quality encoding. So it's like a lower resolution image, but the image itself is closer to the original. It's also a bitrate issue. Twitch's bitrate is extremely, extremely low. So you gotta be... Ow! You don't have... Like, you can't throw data at it. So I try to, process the image a little more locally. Try to get it looking better under the bitrate cap versus just using bits to fill it in. Oh, Jesus, I don't have... Oh, God, they locked me in. Oh, no! Christ. Ah, damn. That was intense. They've kept that same cap for far too long. I agree, but what are you going to do, you know? I agree. I thought when they got acquired by Amazon it was going to go up, but no. And then Amazon's like kicking up Luna, which is a whole cloud-based video compression streaming thing. Still not above 6. I wonder what it is like... There's so many people that stream and they're just like on 0 viewers or like 1 or 2 viewers that if you up the bitrate for everyone like that you're basically like 30% more network traffic across your entire network. So I don't know, maybe it's just that like it's low and then there's just so many streamers that you know aren't really generating revenue. They're incurring costs because they're, you know, just streaming. I guess they don't transcode. You don't get transcoding until you're partnered, though. Well, even still. I think the issue would be like they'd have to tier it somehow that like some streamers get higher bit rates and some don't, and I think that's like not fair. I think logistically they would have to tier it, but I think that would not create a level playing field, you know what I mean? You could definitely incredibly make the case of like how can someone expect to grow if they don't get the same bitrate cap that a popular streamer has? Their stream is always going to look worse, and that's not fair. And they're right. So I don't know. That's kind of what I tend to think about. That maybe that's where they ended up is like if we were to bump it by even 2 megabits per person, that would multiply all of our network traffic by this, and our increased costs would be this. And it never makes sense to do it. Ugh, God. I did not think that was gonna work. I'm not out of the woods yet. It only gives me rockets? Jeez. Anyway, I would like more bitrate. You can push some really crisp streams to YouTube. God damn it. So many enemies! God. Still, the cap isn't scalable for the future. I mean, it's scalable for Twitch. It's scalable until they start losing viewers because people demand to watch streams in 4K. Ugh, those enemies don't drop ammo. Excited for Metroid Dread? Oh, very much so. Yes. I watched both the Treehouse presentations about that game. I'm very excited for it. God! Can't even get over! AWS spin down is the issue. AWS spin up isn't so bad, though. Huh. I don't know much about Amazon Web Services, so... You certainly sound like you know what you're saying, though. Drunk Mario Golf stream this Friday. Yes. Yes. Probably more in the evening, Pacific. I think six or seven was the last time that I saw. Jeez, this level's crazy. Fortunately, I think I need to end there. I did have plans this evening. Gonna hang out with some old friends. Catch up on some things. So, today's stream would have been a lot longer, but, you know, Windows and all that. But I don't think I have a whole lot of plans for tomorrow, and everything's reinstalled and working. So what I wanted to do was, I wanted to get to play a bunch of the stream demos that were in the latest Steam Demo Fest. I installed a ton of them, and I intend to go through them. By God, I'll still do it. I have rockets, but I don't have anything to rock it with. Jesus! It hurts. Nyeh! Dink, dink. Anyway, that's the plan for tomorrow. But yeah, shorter stream today. But I'm glad I could put some time up on the board for my homie Quake. Consider Quake. It's pretty great. I'm gonna come back. I want to come back to this. I want to play through Quake campaign. I was actually saving it for QuakeCon, but anniversary, it was on my mind, and it seemed like a good game to test stream smoothness. The demos had Steamworks integration. There's a good chance they won't launch now. Okay, that's good to know. Well, I guess we'll just play the ones that still work. Anyway, thank you guys all very much for watching. I'm glad that I could get this in. This is very nourishing for me. So good to play Quake. Well, I really enjoyed reading all your memories about LAN parties and stuff like that, so... Alright, but more... Definitely more going on tomorrow on the stream, because like I said, it's all fixed now. More was done today than it seems, I promise, and you'll see the effects of that soon, but... Have a great night, everyone, and I'll catch you next time.